Finally, the heart of your access database is a navigation pane. It shows you what's in the database and makes them easily accessible for you. A Microsoft Access database is made up of several components, including tables, forms, queries, and reports. These components are called database objects. One or more of these objects are formed when a database is created. Let's take a look at the navigation pane and see how it works, and then discuss the database objects. The first thing you'll want to know how to do is work with the navigation pane. To open and close the navigation pane, just click the shutter bar button. With the navigation pane open, you'll see one or more groups. You can collapse and expand a group by simply clicking the down or up double arrows. You can also select the way in which the objects in the database are displayed in the navigation pane. Just click the drop-down arrow here to see your options. You can include the creation or modified dates, or display objects as icons or lists. Let's take a look at tables. To open a table, just click the table icon. Tables are usually created for specific topics. As you can see here, we have a table for our inventory of books. We have columns or fields of information such as title and author. Each row is a record that is comprised of one or more fields. We'll talk more about fields in another lesson. Another database object is called a query. A query lets you find and retrieve information from one or more tables based on a set of search conditions you define by using the fields in one or more tables. Don't worry, we'll look further into queries in a later lesson. You can also use forms with your database. Primarily, people use forms to make data entry to database tables easier. Instead of entering data directly into a table, a user can use an easy-to-read form. The final object I want to show you is the report. A report is an effective way to analyze and present data in a printed format using a specific layout. You have control over the size and appearance of information printed on the report, just like you do with Microsoft Word documents. We will also cover forms and reports in a later lesson. Now, when you're ready to close any of these objects, just notice the tabs to the right of the navigation pane. The highlighted tab is the active tab. In this case, we only have one. And it can be easily closed by clicking the X on the right. Now, as I said before, if access looks a little complex to you right now, don't panic, because additional lessons will cover each of these objects in greater detail.